Namma Veetu Chef.
Welcome, Salam, Namaste. Now, your host and those Sandhya, and I welcome you all to Namma Veetu Chef. Where all warm in the Nigalchil and now, you'll have homemade food where the homemakers themselves share some secret recipes. And this food will not only be loved by your children, but also make a space in your husband's heart through his stomach. So, let's check out what do I get for you today. That the way to a man's heart is through his stomach. So who can be better to ask more than, you know, a husband, of course. So our chef for the today is Kavitha, and right now I have her husband sitting with me. Hi sir, what's your name?
I'm Ashok.
Ashok. And now that I know that you guys are married and you're so, I mean, married for such a long year, indeed proves that, you know, she's a great cook, isn't it?
She's a very good cook, but she hardly cooks.
She hardly cooks.
But she's a good cook, and whatever she makes is really unique, you know. And I'm very careful about my food. What you say is right, you know. The way to a man's heart is through the stomach.
Uh-huh.
But in my case, it's not that, you know.
It is not that. You're very picky when it comes
very,
to food.
I'm very choosy about my
food. That makes the, you know, the work of a woman even more difficult.
No, it makes her life easier, you know. Because what do I have? Cornflakes, etc. You know, very, very light it is.
Right.
So it is not difficult for her. And that is why she's a very good cook, you know.
Oh, that was a clever answer there. Okay, so what does she make that you love the most?
I like her chop suey, you know.
Chop suey.
She makes it, you know.
Okay.
And she makes it really well. She gives it to me about once a week or twice a week, once in 2 weeks,
okay.
That's all. Because it is very fattening, so I'm very careful about that. But she makes that very, very well.
Okay, so normally what happens when you're in a relationship where, you know, your wife is like very particular. Is she like that? Does she, you know, take note of what you eat, what you don't eat?
Oh, she notices everything.
Every particular thing.
And in fact, I tell her, don't watch me so much, you know. I feel very...
Good that she's not hearing all this, otherwise tonight, no food for you.
She knows it. Even when I talk on the phone, she'll tell me, say this, don't say that in action, and that really...
Is there, what kind of a lady she is normally, otherwise?
She's very adjustable.
Adjustable.
Very, very adjustable. She puts up with all my tantrums, with all my difficult, whatever I make her life difficult,
mm-hmm.
with all the difficulties she puts up with, and she's really the right person for me, I would say.
Oh, that's so sweet. I can truly see how much she loves you. And who is this little girl who's sitting with you? Hello. Hi, what's your name?
Saina.
Saina, that's such a pretty name. Do you go to school, Saina? Which class?
I go to Alphabet.
You go to Alphabet school? LKG, is it? Which is your favorite food item?
Palak paneer.
Palak paneer, which grandmom makes, right? Okay, so you want to ask grandmom to make palak paneer tonight? Okay. All right. So we'll see what Kavitha ma'am is making for the day, and we'll eat in the evening, all of us together. So friends, ippo namo or very important segment ke vandirukom, which is the cooking segment, where we'll learn how to make some really yummy dishes. And right now, I have with me Mrs. Kavitha, who's a homemaker. Hi, ma'am.
Hello.
Okay. So how did you start cooking? Is it like something which was forced on you by your mother, or did you start loving cooking when you were growing up?
The way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
Absolutely.
So once you learn to cook and you cook well, you know where you'll be.
Awesome. So was that a secret of your and your husband's getting married?
Partly.
All right.
And when you want your children, they absolutely dote on you when they know they're getting good food at home.
True,
you know?
True. So what are we going to make today? What is our first dish?
Today our first dish is a macaroni and spinach in white sauce.
Wow, macaroni and spinach in white sauce. It sounds yummy. As it is, what do we need for it?
For this, we need macaroni.
Okay.
Which I have boiled.
Okay.
Blanched spinach.
Okay.
Milk, maida, and little bit of cooking oil,
uh-huh.
and cheese.
All right. So, without any further ado, let's just get started.
Wow, once the oil is hot, I take in 1 tablespoon of maida. And I stir it so that there are no lumps.
We have to add maida in hot oil.
On hot oil. Once you see that the color changes slightly, we add in the milk. 1 mug of milk.
It should turn just orangish brown, right? Not completely brown.
Right.
Very light color. Yeah. All the oil has come up, right?
Yeah. Then you keep stirring it till it thickens. This is the basic white sauce, which is used for many baked dishes.
Keep stirring it so that it doesn't stick on the ground.
Round, and it, once you feel it's thickened.
Okay.
A little more.
So the basic idea of stirring it all the time is that it shouldn't form lump as we have added maida in it. And it should also not stick on the ground because the temperature is a little hot. If you feel it sticking a bit, just reduce the temperature.
Absolutely. Add a little bit of salt.
A bit of salt to taste. The macaroni that we are adding is already boiled.
Okay.
As you can see, the paste is getting thicker and thicker. After a point, after like a few minutes, the macaroni will start absorbing the milk.
Absolutely.
And now you can add the spinach. The color is giving it such a beautiful look, right, ma'am?
Yes.
So we've added all the ingredients into this. Well, friends, as you can see that it doesn't even take a lot of your time. Anje anje minisho it will be taking. And now I think within 2 minutes it'll get done. So with dark green mixed in white.
Children love it. And you can enjoy it with even garlic toast.
Okay. And it is also very healthy, isn't
it? Yeah.
So when you want your children to eat healthy, you should present the food really well to them. So I think this could be one of the dishes. If you want to make it a little spicy,
Can add chili flakes to
it. Chili flakes to it, okay. This is while cooking or while eating you can
add? No, when you are putting in the dish, you can just add chili flakes.
Okay.
You add a little bit of cheese inside, and then before serving, you can add a little bit of cheese again.
What cheese is this, ma'am?
This you can
normal,
use the
regular
normal
cheese?
Cheese.
Okay.
Okay. I
so
think
the normal
done.
Cheese that you get, you have to grate it and then
and
add
just
it on.
Just add
the dish.
It to it.
And we are done.
Yeah, we are done.
So as you saw, it doesn't even take. Can you see when I switch it off?
Yeah, sure.
So friends, as you saw that it doesn't even take 5 minutes, you can get it done with it, that instant 2 minutes, which actually a lot of other brands have claimed, but you can make this one in 2 minutes really. So we can pour it
into this.
So the dish is ready
and we will garnish it with little bit of
cheese,
grated cheese. This is all ready to eat. You can make garlic toast and serve it with garlic toast.
Okay, so is this is there any kind of secret ingredient that you put over here and you're not telling us? So this is it.
One of the main ingredients which I have put and I should tell you is when you cook food, the main ingredient should be love. When you put love and affection, the food is always very, very tasty.
All right, thank you so much, ma'am.
Now my dish is ready. You can taste it and let me know how
it's. I'll surely taste this, ma'am, but I don't think this is the right time because we have one more dish for you and we'll quickly see the ingredients and how that dish is made. But and after that, we'll come to your home and we'll taste this.
Oh, you're most welcome. I'd love it.
Okay.
Once the oil is hot, I take in 1 tablespoon of maida. Once you see that the color changes slightly, 1 mug of milk. Keep stirring it till it thickens.
Okay.
We'll add a little bit of salt.
The macaroni that we are adding is already boiled.
Okay.
The macaroni will start absorbing the milk.
Absolutely.
And now you can add the spinach.
You add a little bit of cheese inside, and then before serving you can add a little bit of cheese. To eat, you can make garlic toast and serve it with garlic toast. So the second dish is chicken corn soup. For that, I need chicken stock, which I have prepared by boiling the chicken with a little bit of peppercorns and ginger.
Okay.
We pour the...
We'll switch on the gas.
And we add the chicken stock.
So chicken stock is a very simple thing that you can prepare at home itself.
Yeah, definitely.
When you're boiling the chicken, all you have to do is you have to add a little ginger and little pepper to it. And the residue, you can take it over. Don't throw the water.
To this chicken stock, I add cream style corn. This is usually available in the market.
These are the frozen corn that will be there in the market?
Yes, yes. These things are available in the market.
So you can add it to your chicken stock.
Yeah.
Basically, we are using the leftover water of the boiled chicken because we get the essence of chicken.
The flavor of chicken comes. Just add it, keep stirring till it just comes to a boil.
Okay.
Then to a little bit of chicken stock which I have over here, I add 1 tablespoon of corn flour.
Okay.
To thicken it. Okay.
Corn flour, maida, whatever you have, little bit of it to the leftover water.
I've kept a little aside and I've...
Maybe like a cup of water?
No, just about half a cup of water.
Half a cup of water. And one big tablespoon
of corn flour.
Okay. Nicely stir it so that it doesn't have any lumps in it.
Correct.
Because if you have lump while you have the soup, you'll get the taste of maida in your mouth. As you can see, we have the soup getting boiled over here very nicely. We have to add salt, pepper at the same time.
Yes, you will. Once you add this, you will add your shredded chicken also. When you have boiled the chicken, you have some chicken. You will add the shredded chicken also.
Okay. So this chicken is already boiled, so don't overdo it when you're adding it into it. Make sure that only one boil should come after you add the boiled chicken into it, right?
Correct.
Otherwise, it'll become very slimy.
We add a little bit of salt.
To taste.
Once this comes to a boil, we add the corn flour to thicken it.
So do you have little children at home, ma'am, who love
I have. Cooking? This is my granddaughter's favorite.
Acha? How old is she?
She's 5.
Oh.
And today when you come and taste it, she will sit with you and enjoy it.
Oh, that's great. I'm willing to meet her. As you can see that she's just 5 years old, and if she loves that soup, trust me, any kid would love it, because these days 5 years olds are very clever. So the chicken corn soup is almost ready. We'll have small steps also left. So come back after this small little break. We'll taste the dishes after that, and also the soup will be ready by then. And I think the corn soup is almost getting ready. So we'll ask Kavitha ma'am, what is the next ingredient that is to be put into this? Now you can see how nice
now
and
it has thickened.
The corn will automatically get cooked inside that.
It's already partially cooked in the tin. It's called cream style corn.
Cream style corn.
Now you will take an egg, crack the egg.
Just the egg white if you
want.
Fully.
Fully.
What about the people who are little fitness freaks?
One yolk is fine. I have all of them at home are fitness freaks.
Okay.
So I'm always very careful with what I serve them. You just beat the eggs. Just lightly beat it.
Okay.
And add it. And while you're adding it, you have to stir it. You'll see the magic.
Oh, wow. add it directly to it?
No, then your white and yellow will be separate. But when you mix, okay. Yes. But when you do this, you will get a mixture of.
Well, both. As all of us know that probably the white gets cooked first and then the yellow.
Yes.
So if you add the mixture directly to our soup over here, the white and yellow get separated.
Correct.
So nalla beat panni, when you are mixing it, keep mixing, keep stirring
it. Soup. And now okay. Your soup is ready.
Chicken corn soup.
You should try it.
So I'm definitely going to come to your place and I'm going to taste these dishes. And
I'm looking forward to you coming and we all are going to be waiting for you and we are going to eat together.
Sure. And okay. I want your 5-year-old daughter to
definitely. Me. She'll be there before all of us.
Okay,
to greet
great.
You.
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, it's time to move on to her place and taste the dishes. Come over. Come on.
Thank you. Stock which I have prepared by boiling the chicken with little bit of peppercorns and ginger. To this chicken stock I add cream style corn. Just add it, keep stirring till it just comes to a boil. I add 1 tablespoon of corn flour.
Soup getting boiled over here very nicely.
You will add the shredded chicken also.
Okay.
We add little bit of salt.
To taste.
Comes to a boil, we add the corn flour. Now you will take an egg, lightly beat it and add it, and while you are adding it, you have to stir it. And now your soup is ready. Now the food is all ready. I'd like you to taste it and tell me how it is.
Definitely. All the hard work put is now going to serve. The entire family is here.
Yeah.
Not the full family, but if you can introduce whoever we have here with us.
My husband.
Yes, of course, my husband. We've already spoken to him.
And my granddaughter. All I told right. you she's very fond of the corn soup, so I made sure that she's here.
All right. So you like corn soup as well? She told me that she likes only palak paneer.
Yes.
You like only palak paneer or do you like corn soup as well?
Corn soup.
You like the corn soup most? Did your grandma mom told you to say corn soup? No.
Mama didn't say, Big Mama didn't say. You don't like it, right?
Alright, so the corn soup is here. So what do you prefer? Which one do you want to go for first?
I'll go for the soup first.
Alright, so I don't think we should wait anymore. Let's just see how the food tastes.
Basically, whenever we go to a restaurant, she orders for this soup.
Okay.
And because she orders it, we all have it together. You know?
Oh.
And it's very good, you know.
So that's how we got to know that Saina loves corn soup. Saina, you like it, right? Is it nice?
Yes.
Is it a little spicy?
No.
No?
I liked it very much. It's very, very good.
How did you like the food? It's very,
very
nice?
Very good. Very nice.
Are you just saying it because she's sitting
next
to you?
Not at all. It was really very good. I like spinach.
Okay.
And I like the bread. It's brown bread. It's okay. Everything is very good. Fantastic.
How's the blend of... can you feel that flour that she has added?
No, actually I did not.
You did not at all. So is it like, this one is better or the white pasta, white macaroni that you've eaten outside?
I like this one more.
Any different food is better and more.
Actually, I don't have too much of pastas, but I like this one very much.
I could see, you know, you're taking two fillings, three fillings already. All right, great. I don't want to put jinx over there, but great. So as I was saying that, you know, this spinach in the pasta doesn't even seem like it is actually, you know, doesn't even taste like spinach. What do you think, ma'am, since you've only made it?
I have nothing to say. I'll see what you all say. And if you all like it, I'm really very happy about it.
We loved it. But is there anything that, you know, you have to say as in, why, you know, people should try this once?
This is all very, very healthy food, you know, not much of oil put in it, not much of cooking. So, children all enjoy this kind of food. So, I think you all should try it out.
Okay,
it's very simple to make also.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you in the show room. If next enna pannanum ungalku nalla theriyum, you have to go on to www.facebook.com/peppers and share your views, because your likes, comments and feedbacks are very, 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 very important to us. I'll come back next week again. Until then, this is the host and those Sandhya saying bye. Namma Veetu Chef.